In this tutorial, we will read a live RSS feed of traffic incidents in XML format, create points of each incident location, set a coordinate system, and write them out to KML format. We will demonstrate how to use feature paths when reading the XML data. Our source data of traffic incidents is assessed via a URL. With the Internet Explorer option, Feed Reading View, turned on, we see a nicely structured page with the incidents. With the Feed Reading View checked off, we see the nested XML, and we can clearly see that the item element contains the incident details. Let's view this data using the FME Data Inspector. Type in XML for the format. A list of XML-based formats appears. Frequently used XML profiles are often implemented as their own FME format, reader, and writer. So it's best to first check if there is a specific reader-writer for the XML file you are trying to read. In this case, there is not, so we will select XML for the format. For the dataset, enter the following URL. When selecting this format, it's important to tell FME how to map the XML elements to feature types and attributes. Open the parameters and set the configuration type to feature paths. Next, identify the element tags to map for feature extraction. Click next to Elements to Match. In this tree view, we can check which nodes we want to become feature types. Let's open RSS, then Channel, and select Item. Click OK to close the dialogs. FME will scan your data and create feature types based on a flattening of your XML at the nodes specified in your feature path. We have 10 features in the item feature type. It is non-spatial, but we do have latitude and longitude values, which we can use to create points in FME Workbench. Let's do that now. In FME Workbench, we will add the XML reader and read the dataset again with the same parameters we just used in the FME Data Inspector. To create points, add a vertex creator transformer and connect its input to the item source feature type. Set the X, Y values to long, lat, respectively. Then add a coordinate system setter to set the coordinate system to a lat-long WGS84 coordinate system. Connect an inspector. Go ahead and run the workspace to confirm that we have points. We will make them red and increase the point size to see them more clearly. Let's set up the workspace to write to KML. We will add a KML writer and add a location to write the dataset to. The Copy From Reader Schema option will copy the schema from the source XML feature type to the destination KML feature type. Before we connect things up, let's set some KML properties and styling. Add a KML property setter to the workspace. Open its properties and set Category for the name and Description for the summary. These will appear in the Google Earth navigation tree. We will use the description also for the KML balloon content. Next, we will add a KML styler to change the point icon style. Open its properties, expand the icon section, and select the E5 icon. Now connect the KML styler to the destination feature type. Let's also clean up the attributes. Open the properties of the KML feature type. Click on the User Attributes tab and remove the attributes prefixed with XML copied from the source. Go ahead and run the workspace. Double-click on the output KML file to see the results in Google Earth.